different ball flights. It's great to have these in your bag, and if you can play high and low as well as your normal shot, you're going to be certainly onto a winner whenever you need to call on these shots throughout the whole of your golf round. Well, in this video, I'm going to delve right into that and show you exactly how I play them and how you could add these things into your game to be able to help you. So let's get stuck in. This is Nick Does Golf. Hey golfers, and welcome back to another video here on my channel, Nick Does Golf. It's great to have you here for this one. Today I'm going to be talking about how you hit a low shot and those high ones as well. So let's get stuck in right away. So in order to play these, you need to make some adjustments to your setup and also to your swing as well. If we focus on the low one to start with, here I've got a 7-iron. If I wanted to hit a low one, first thing that I'm going to do is I'm going to grip down on the club from there. This is going to encourage more control with the golf club, and it's also going to slow your club head speed down a fraction. You don't want to create as much spin on the golf ball because you want to keep it nice and low. Say for example you're going under some trees, this is certainly going to help with that. So gripping down is number one. Another one is your ball position. You're going to set it back in your stance. This is to encourage that downward blow on it to be able to hit it nice and low with that reduced revs per minute on the golf ball. Your hands are going to be slightly forwards again to help with that compression, and your body weight is going to be leaning forwards. If I wanted to hit something low, I'm going to be looking low. I wouldn't be looking up in the air like that or looking where my normal shot is going to go. I want to be driving that ball low, down, under something or around it so I can get that ball to advance to the position that I want to. So they're just your setup ones. For the swing, obviously you're not going to be taking this club back as far because you want to cut it off in order to create that less spinning golf ball. So if I was to take it 3/4 of the way back, I want to mimic that on the way through and cut it off as soon as I can. The more I can do that, the more penetrating the ball flight is going to be, the better the result. So this is in direct contrast to the high shot. You want to pretty much do the opposite of all of this. So gripping high on the golf club so you can create as much club head speed as possible to get that ball spinning and up and over that object. Also putting your ball position slightly further forward than normal is going to be key. If you can get your hands to be pretty much where they were at a normal shot, that'll be ideal. You don't really want them to be too far behind the golf ball because that's not going to help. But having that ball position higher is going to create your shoulders to get slightly more angled up towards the sky, and then because you're going to be looking higher, this is going to help as well, so you can get over that object as quickly as possible. So if you wanted to hit it higher, you'd be looking at getting that swing nice and high, getting those hands as high as you can, so you can generate as much ball speed and promote that ball flight as high as possible. Obviously these shots are going to be dependent on the ball flight that you need and the trajectory of the shot as well. These are really going to be pivotal things that you need to work on to be able to get better at. What I would advise is to play around with it and practice it. Take it to the extremes, put that ball flight to the back foot, see what it feels like, see how you hit it, also maneuver your hands. If you can practice these and work on them to the best of your ability, then you're going to be held in better stead for whenever you need these shots out on the golf course. So I hope you found this video beneficial for these different ball flights. If you have, hit the like button and leave a comment down below. Let me know, what do you do to be able to make that ball go lower or higher? As well as that, if you're following the series and you haven't subscribed yet, why not? Come on, you can do it. Hit that big red subscribe button down below. I'd really appreciate it as I go through this journey with you. As well as that, check out my social media platforms. I'm on Instagram, Twitter and TikTok, so you can keep up to date with everything that I'm doing. So I hope that has really helped you. Get to work, team. Thanks very much for watching, and see you on the next one.